Hello and welcome. Today our backdrop is the sunny downtown Atlanta. Atlanta is a city filled with progress and promise. Like several modern cities, Atlanta is constantly reinventing and restructuring itself to improve the conditions of our future, our next generation. Our Seeds Tomorrow, located in Atlanta, was founded with the same ideals in mind. To improve the condition of our seeds, our future, our youth. Created by Dazia, Fumbah, who sought to provide a safe haven, comfort, and stability to Liberian children following the Civil War, this organization thrives under unlikely circumstances and in impoverished communities. Our Seeds Tomorrow provides the hope that they cannot do it alone. When I met Mr. Dazia and Fumbah last summer, I was impressed by his passion, by his persistence, and his vision to educate the world around him through the life of a child. His mission focuses on sustainability, universal education, and empowerment, without which we cannot thrive. These values can make a true difference in our world, today and tomorrow. It takes a village to raise a child, and we all know we need to work together. Mr. Fumbah needs your support. I am Sumatra Nana, a global educator, philanthropist, and event planner. And I am delighted to present... Hello, I am Sumatra Nana, supporter of Our Seeds Tomorrow, and I'm here with Dazia Fumbah, who created and founded Our Seeds Tomorrow. Dazia, welcome.
Well, it's a pleasure meeting you, Sumatra. Give me a hug.
Atlanta. Welcome to Atlanta.
Thanks a lot.
Yes, absolutely.
It's an honor just being with you, our educator, giving back to Africa and the rest of the world. I'm delighted to be here today.
Wonderful. Tell us more about your vision. When did you say, I'm going to create Our Seeds Tomorrow to make this difference? What was your vision?
First, let's go back and talk about some of the perpetuation legacy that led me to this position. I'm from a family of powerful chiefs. My grandfather was a family former from the Zaza district. He built schools and claimed it for the people.
Mm.
He empowered the people. And I had an auntie called Patricia B. Kennedy. She built schools also. My father also was an educator. He was a principal.
Wow.
Yes. He was a principal and in education. He did education at the University of Liberia. And also, he taught in Liberia. I had an uncle that was a principal for the World Jewish Government High School, William Momolu, that was an educator all his life in Liberia.
Ah.
My mother also was a teacher. So I came up in this family of education.
I'm Fakola Amandu Sirleaf Jr. And first of all, I want to go ahead and pause before I get further into my delivery. I want to thank Mr. Dazia Fumbah for birthing and leading this movement. Our next generation of future leaders, of future community activists, will be ours to groom and to grow. So for that, I commend him and I continue to lend my support. I'm honored to lend my voice to this initiative. Having talked to me about it, Our Seeds Tomorrow is a program where we strive to prepare tomorrow's generation and future leaders of our beloved country. And therefore, we all have a stake in this. I was fortunate to grow up in the home and be the son of Fakuma Amadou Sirleaf Sr. and my beloved mother, Irene W. Sirleaf, who was both of them were educators. So early on, growing up, we knew the importance of being educated. And we had some formal education, grew up on great institutes within the Liberia scene in Kakata. I know most of you would know about the Booker T. Washington Institute. But let's just talk about a few basic things about education, about preparations, about succeeding tomorrow. I mean, growing up, I always knew because of a household of great people like W.E.B. Du Bois, like Booker T. Washington, and my father as well has been one of those great people who have contributed to our society in many, many ways, left legacy of other people who are prepared to lead today because of what they were able to do for us previously. And now we come to our generation. You always understood that there are certain things afflicting the Liberian society as a whole. And we knew of three things in my generation and in my household: ignorance, disease, and poverty. Unfortunately, those things are still chronic and still systemic within our Liberian community today. So I'm just going to lend a few things that I think are practical, I think are call to actions, and each of us can start doing that. Now, in one of his previous speech, Booker T. Washington, who is a pioneer of the Negro education within the American society, made a comment to his group and acknowledged this and said, "The most intelligent of us is always dumbed down by the ignorance of our brethren." That is not a direct quote, but understand that what he's saying is that no matter how intelligent, how educated you become, both formal education or informal education, our education does not shine as bright as it should if our brethren is also uneducated. Therefore, each one teach one. It's a philosophy that's always been ingrained in me, and I want to pass on to you, and I really want this to be a call to action. If at all, we all acknowledge that the infrastructures needed to be able to reach our masses are not already in place in Liberia, then it is a simple choice. We have to make sure that those infrastructures become available, because there are two essential things that must be met in preparing our seeds for tomorrow. One, affordability. Can we afford to be able to send our kids to a school to prepare them formally to compete with the many challenges to drive out ignorance, disease, and poverty? Along with affordability comes accessibility. If I were to go into my father's hometown, Bopolu, now it's called Bopolu in Liberia, are there schools? Are there programs available where the wiser of the community or the most educated of the community or teachers coming into the community can set down a group of young boys and girls, men and women, because education does not span only to the young ones. Is there that availability, access to formal education? So the challenge is, as you answer these questions internally, what can I do to be able to create access and affordability? And I tell you one thing you can do as a person. Number one, you can go to www.ourseedstomorrow.org and lend your support for this prestigious effort of call to action. Lend your support financially, lend your time, lend your experiences, lend your successes. And by doing so, you have transition to the forum where now each one is reaching one to teach one. For closing, I just want to commend my brother Dazia Fumbah again for birthing and leading this effort. This is a tremendous call to action, and we all should answer it by saying we are all committed to the development of our youth for tomorrow.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Ladia Kennedy, and I'm reporting for Radio Kilimanjaro. I'm honored to be standing here with the founder of Radio Kilimanjaro, as well as the founder of ourseedtomorrow.org, Mr. Dazia Fumbah. ourseedtomorrow.org, tell us about the dream, the vision, the organization.
Around 2 o'clock in the morning, usually I start my work. Sometimes 12 o'clock, sometimes 11 to 6 in the morning is when the most of my creation are usually done. Even back during the days when I was involved into music, it was around about 2 o'clock in the morning one night, rainy night. The word "I will see you tomorrow" was given to me. And eventually, I did not even know the purpose of "I will see you tomorrow." I did not even know what to do with "I will see you tomorrow." I took "I will see you tomorrow" and I pray about it. I went to God, I said, "God, what is your purpose? What is the reason? What should I do with this?" Fortunate to me that he revealed to me in a dream. Most of the time in my life, I would see myself running in schools playing with children. Children, handicapped children, deaf children, children of all different challenges. And we would just horse play around, have fun, and just laugh. And I continue to pray. Finally, God showed me a project that will have something to do with school building projects. And I knew eventually it was a profound purpose to build schools to empower the children. The overseas tomorrow is the next generation. The name and the meaning of our seeds tomorrow is our children tomorrow. It's our future tomorrow. It's our leaders tomorrow. The children is our future. They are our future. They are our hopes. They are our dreams. I will ask you to join the movement by visiting www.oursedestomorrow.org. Let's make a difference. Let's give the children hope of prosperity. The only difference between a poor child and a rich child is opportunity. Let's bridge the gap and give them love. That they will have strength. That they will have confidence. And they will know who they are. That they can know their identity, culture, and history. And they can develop and return back to the civil society and impart and emulate the same example that we are given today through the foundation of our seeds tomorrow. Let's touch life. Let's make a difference. We all going to be on a year very soon in a short period of time. The question is, what you want your foundation, your offspring, and your seed to look like 5 to 10 years from now, 15 to 20 years. We should be part of this conversation and join the movement because we want the result of our children. That we should have a hands. We should have something to do with the development. It is why we as people came through other parish that touched our life. We are emulating the same example by giving back, by making a difference, by guiding them, by loving them, creating opportunity through the blessings of God, the abundance of blessings to our future, hope, by planting seeds through education, and creating, developing, giving education for the next generation of future purification. My name is Dazia Fumbah. I am the executive director, founder of the LC's Tomorrow Project. I want to say thanks for coming in, bringing your talents, bringing your gifts, bringing your financial support. If even it is not this foundation, join another foundation. Make a difference in Haiti, in Jamaica, in Togo, in Liberia, right in Atlanta, Georgia, in the United States, Minnesota. There are a lot of children that are deprived of opportunity. They are bright. All of these kids are bright just like any other wealthy kids. The only thing that they don't have is just the opportunity or chance for someone to hold their hands and take them along the way. Support them, encourage them. Together, we can succeed. Thank you very much. And may the Lord continue to bless each and every one of you as you give your talent, your gifts, that He will continue to give you abundance of blessings.